we digitally made our own Neanderthal and humans on a program called Active World. And so what we did was we used the faces that we had made and all of the skeletal structures that we had looked at in the halls to make what we thought a Neanderthal would look like.
My favorite part of the program was the virtual worlds.
I learned about genetics, I learned about fossil evidence.
There's pictures somewhere.
What happened to the Neanderthals is our latest and most exciting installment of the Middle School Institutes, in which middle school kids who are passionate about science and curious about the natural world can come to the Museum of Natural History and learn with each other. They work with scientists and educators, they explore the fossils at the museum, they get to go behind the scenes, and they're really allowed to explore topics that are often not covered in schools.
When we're reconstructing a virtual world like this, we're using data in the computer, but all of the data that we have in this computer comes from the real world. The kids are actually using fossils and artifacts, and they're trying to recreate that as best they can here in the virtual world so that they can then communicate that to other people.
My name is Samara Rubenstein. I'm the manager of this Sackler Educational Laboratory here in the Hall of Human Origins at the American Museum of Natural History. I have a PhD in physical anthropology, and I'm lucky enough to create curricula and develop courses for middle school and high school students who can learn about human evolution and ask themselves the questions that scientists are investigating today. And they can use all of the evidence found in the hall and in the lab to answer these questions.
Being able to go into a virtual world and design characters and customize different things, I thought this was a really cool experience to try to learn more about this subject.